ZNS Total Sports is brought to you by Fourth Terrace Diagnostic Center.
Good evening, Bombers. I'm Amajal Knowles with your ZNS Total Sports. We're roughly 24 hours out from the Makers Wanted Bahamas Bowl, and the University of Charlotte 49ers and the University of Buffalo Bisons are more than ready to make history and kick off the 150th anniversary of college football with the opening bowl game on the 2019-2020 calendar. But football aside, the coaches and players said they have been certainly soaking up the time in the 2-4-2.
Just giving our guys this experience makes me sleep easier. So many of our guys have never been to a beach. A lot of the guys that didn't travel this year had never been on a plane before. The bowl gifts, the hospitality is first class. So we take a lot of pride on. Nobody gives our student athletes a better experience than what we do. And to add this trip to the repertoire has been amazing. But I would say my five-year-old on the Rapid River and the slides has been probably my most memorable part of this.
Being able to spend this time with my teammates at Atlantis, just being able to be outside of our normal element. We're not in the locker room, we're not at the field house. This is a brand new element for us, and just all of us being able to interact, especially the seniors. We couldn't have had a better bowl destination, and we're just blessed just to be here.
Just being able to spend this time in Atlantis, you know, with my brothers, like that's just been, you know, unforgettable. You know, it's been so amazing so far. You know, for me, I've just finally seen some clear water. It was really awesome. I went to Clearwater Beach earlier in the year, and I thought I was going to see clear water, and it wasn't really clear. So I finally got to see some clear water and went out there. The first thing, you know, we got here, ate lunch, and as soon as we got back to the rooms, went to the beach. And so that was really nice. But, you know, kind of like Cam said, you know, just being able to spend this time, this once-in-a-lifetime trip, you know, with your brothers is really awesome.
And for the players and coaches from the University of Buffalo, the Bahamas is definitely a far cry from upstate New York.
Probably the weather, you know, being from Buffalo, you know, it's very cold. Just, you know, just seeing, you know, the scenery here and just the weather has been an amazing experience for me and my teammates.
Families coming down now and just being able to experience the whole atmosphere together as a big football family.
You know, adding to what they said, I think when you watch your families have the experiences that they've never seen, to see, you know, this country for what it has and presents. I know for our family, we've never been here, and my wife's already talking about when the return trip is going to be made and how soon. But it's weather, it's the scenery, it's the beach, but just like everything we want to do in our program, it's really about people, and your hospitality has been second to none.
In more college football news, another Bahamian football player has been awarded the opportunity to play collegiate football at the D1 level. This week, four-star Bahamian defensive end Elijah Roberts signed his letter of intent to play at the University of Miami next fall. He attended Miami Columbus High. At Columbus, Roberts won the Florida Class 8A title against Apopka High earlier this year, 21-20. Roberts committed to Miami over offers from South Carolina, Florida, Florida State, and Georgia Tech from his list of 18 scholarship offers. On the 24/7 Sports composite site, Roberts is ranked as the number 55 defensive end in the state of Florida and the number 324 overall player in all of high school football. In tennis news, well, the Giorgio Baldacci Senior Tennis Nationals are well underway. We caught up with some of the younger stars from the tournament to recap their 2019, as well as give us their plans for 2020.
Yes, I'm very happy with how my 2019 has went. I finished off as the overall female junior athlete of the year, so I was really excited for that accomplishment, and I hope to continue with another success here. 2020, I'm planning on going to college as well. I'll be going in September 2020. So I'll just be training, playing tournaments just as usual, and just making my way to the college stage.
2019 is a pretty good year overall. I think I played some of my best tennis this year. I improved a lot on certain strokes, so it's been a pretty good year this far. 2020, I just want to do my best and just try to get my ITF ranking as high as I can, just to do my best and get out there.
In baseball news, former pro baseball player Anton Richardson thought his pioneering major league career was over when he announced his retirement in 2017. It turns out that retirement was just the beginning of Richardson's baseball journey. The former outfielder who played with the Giants, Rangers, Braves, and Orioles, and most notably the New York Yankees, has been hired by the Toronto Blue Jays as the outfield coordinator in the player development department. In his new role, Richardson will be responsible for leading a team of coaches tasked with developing major league prospects in the minors. Commenting on his new role, Richardson said, "It's humbling to be asked to take on this responsibility." Since his retirement, Richardson has spent most of his time traveling locally and internationally, speaking to and encouraging young people on their life journeys. His heart has been entrenched at home, where he volunteers his time mentoring youth in the Bahamas through Project Limestone, a nonprofit organization he established shortly after his retirement. In his new capacity, Richardson believes there will be even more opportunities and doors open for Bahamians beyond the playing field. And that's been a look at sports. Quick check on weather is up next.